to my YouTube channel. This is Richard, owner of Cutting Up Lawn Care and Development, where quality gets quantity. And this for today is Bradley's 200 hour review. Let's get it. All right, what's up? So we about to give you a walk around of the 36 inch Bradley mower. See that big boy's got plenty of power in a small package. And like I said, I've had it for a year and a half, and it's got about 200 hours on it, and I want to give you a review. So let's start from now. So walking around this mower, there's a couple things that I like and I dislike, but I've just, you know, the things that I dislike, I've learned to live with, because it's really not that drastic, you know what I'm saying? So let's start with the parking brake here. So my parking brake, this is when it's up. In travel mode, this is when it's down. So these mowers, I like, you know, if you're mowing very close to something like a bush or a tree, it's easy for one of those branches to hit this parking brake and lock you up. And trust me, it's happened to me a couple times, and it will stop you dead in your tracks. So that's one thing you want to be careful about, is the parking brake. Pad. What I like about this is, the gas can is angled, easy to get to. You know, I could just stick the fuel tank in there. I can see my fuel gauge, my hydraulics. One thing I will tell you about this mower is, when I first got it, let me put the pad back on real quick. That's how it looks with the pad on it. So when I first got it, I always used to hit my legs on these metal parts, and man, these things hurt. So I kind of wish that they could have made like maybe some type of padding here, you know what I'm saying, to make it a little bit more comfortable. But now that I've had it for a year, I've learned to get used to it, and just, you know, maneuver my body out the way when I see bumps. Another thing that I want to show you guys on here is, if you could zoom in at the very bottom. So I don't know if y'all can see, but that mower sits very low to the ground. You have maybe, I want to say, 2 to 3 inches of clearance. Okay, so you have maybe 2 or 3 inches of clearance. As you can see, that mower sits very low to the ground. So if you're rolling over like a tree branch or a root that's coming out of the ground, it will get hung up on that very easily, and you would have to rock yourself off of that. Just because they sit very low, and these mowers, they're very heavy. They weigh about 956 pounds, so almost a half a ton, this little mower. Let's see, the controls, I have no issue with the controls. Everything's very simple. As you can see, normal wear and tear, the padding's coming off a little bit on both, but you know, that's not an issue. The controls are very simple, very easy to use. No problem there. Let's go over here to the deck height. So this is how you raise and lower the deck. Right, so this is how you raise and lower the deck. Now, when I first started, it came with this pin right here, which you have to take the cotter pin out to remove it out of whatever slot you want to put it in, right? So I went to the GIE Expo, and I went to the Bradley booth, and they gave me this bad boy, which, as you can see, I simply just pulled that out of the hole. I don't have a pin to insert on the other end. I just press this button, and bam, it's not moving. It's secure. Put it down to 2, and simple as that. So that's another thing I've changed. As you can see, I got the grass chute from Green Guard that you know, opens manually or by the push of a button. It was very simple to install. The only thing I have to do is, if you go lower and you look lower, this flap does not cover the whole
opening of my grass chute, so I just have to order me a longer flap that covers this down. But I've really had no problems with it. So once again, yeah, this flap doesn't go all the way down to my opening, and so I just have to get a replacement flap that's longer. I'm gonna go to greenguard.com and check them out and get a new one. And then if you can look right here, if you could see, there's a little opening right here. So when I get my new one, I'm kind of just gonna bend it so where the grass doesn't shoot up in my face. Another thing that I've changed on the mower are the front wheels or casters. Now these ones on the ground are the ones that they came with. Those are air filled. And so I replaced them with solid tires, meaning I don't have to put any air in them. And the reason I did that is because when I first got these, I kept having to put air in them every day just because they're a small tire, you know? And so in the cold, I would have to keep putting air in them. And I got tired of that. So I just replaced them with the solid tires. No air, I've had no problems. I've jumped up on sidewalks with that bad boy, and it's no issue. No matter how much I stand on it, it's not gonna go flat. One thing I want to show you about the inside of this deck. So as you can see, this is where the belts are, the pulleys. As you can see, even though it would seem like it's sealed up when I put the cover on it, a lot of debris gets in here. I do a lot of leaf cleanups with this mower, and I have to clean this out a lot because a lot of debris gets in there. And, you know, something you want to pay attention to. A couple of other things you want to be cautious about. Let's look down at the tires. So these are some narrow tires. This machine does not take heels very good, and I'm guessing just because it's a smaller footprint and the tires are thinner. But yeah, you want to take extra caution on those heels. People, so my God's honest opinion about this mower is, if I had to do it over,
I would probably purchase another Bradley mower. Now, that's not saying nothing against my Gravely mower, because my Gravely mower is excellent. It's an awesome machine. Now, we're talking about price points. Here's what I paid for my Bradley back in July of 2020. I have to go back with Bradley. So like I said, if I had, you know, if I knew what I know now, I would have went with another Bradley just for the price point. You know, I was kind of skeptical at first because, you know, we're trained to believe that something cheaper may not be as good. You know, we see something expensive and we automatically be like, oh yeah, it's got to be the top notch. And that's not always the case. And so, like I said, I use this mower all year round in the busiest of my busy seasons, where I'm hitting 8 to 10 yards a day, turning the mower on and off, and, you know, just going through the hot Georgia summers that, you know, Georgia produces. And I've had no issues with this mower. Everything that I had to replace on it so far has been easy. It's just because I talked to customer service. Shout out to Chris over there at Bradley Mowers. You know, he broke a couple things down for me. I had to change a drive belt on here because it was starting to get chewed up a little bit. And I called customer service to see how to replace this thing, because I couldn't figure it out. And he walked me right through it. And, you know, after that, it's been a simple process. And so even when I go to purchase the parts, you know, with the owner's manual, you get a book with all the parts exploded on there, so you can be able to see it correctly. And with the parts are SKU numbers, so whatever parts you need, just write down the SKU number, and when you call, give them that number. And so they're in Illinois, I'm in Georgia. Normally when I order parts, I probably get them in like 4 to 5 days. You know, after I get off the phone with customer service, I receive my parts in about 4 to 5 days. And what I do is I order stuff that I'm gonna need for the whole season. You know, I don't order it as I need it. So like, I still have 2 sets of mulching blades, an extra drive belt. Anything that I replace, I get something extra of. And then like oils and stuff, I just buy that in bulk and put it off to the side. But yeah, this Bradley mowers, not too many people know about them out here in Georgia, at least when I bought mine back in 2020. Not too many people heard of them. So there's not a lot of shops out here that service Bradley mowers. I'm pretty sure, you know, once, if you get into the mechanics of it, it's just like any other mower. But not too many people heard of them. And so I do all the repairs on my mower. And, you know, they're simple when you have good customer service reps to speak to. And so that's pretty much it, guys. If you have whether you have a small business or an established business, I recommend this mower. Do not let the price point fool you. It is a workhorse. And it does everything this big girl know how to do for half the price. And even a smaller footprint. I'm actually thinking about getting like maybe a 48 or a 52 Bradley. Just an extra one. But yeah, so let me know if you guys out there have a Bradley mower, or you know what your experience is with Bradley. Leave it in the comment section. Let me know what you think. And don't forget to like this video, share this video, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I'm always trying to update you on things that I experience in my small business as I'm trying to grow this business into a company. And I just want to share those experiences with you, and so you could have some type of template to go off of. Basically, you know, when I started, yeah, so anyway, when I started lawn care, I didn't have too many mentors to go off of. And so that's I wound up turning to YouTube, and YouTube you know, helped kill my learning curve a lot. And I just got to experience things for myself instead of taking people's word for it. But again, yeah, this is about Bradley today. So yeah, this was it, guys. Let me know what you think. Awesome machine right here. 25 horses. And it goes about 10 miles an hour forward. I don't know, backwards, they say maybe 4 or 5 miles an hour, but it does 10 miles an hour going forward. So yeah, you definitely want to get your practice on before you hop on one of these bad boys and just think you're gonna you know, giddy up, because it'll take you where you want to go very fast. So yep, that's it. Hope y'all have a good one, and see y'all on the next video. Peace.